D'Anthony back on the stand with some snappy testimony.
No, sir, you are badgering me. You're trying to get me upset, sir.
I'm Bob Keeling. I'll break down the day's most dramatic day in the Casey Anthony murder trial.
Plus, a local grandmother and grandson found alive.
Hours of searching and a successful result. Where a local grandmother and her grandson were found and why they were there in the first place.
WESH 2 News at 5 starts now.
First at 5, Casey Anthony's father and her lead attorney involved in a heated give and take in court. Good evening. I'm Jim Payne.
I'm Martha Sagowski. George Anthony was called to the witness stand today for the second time in his daughter's murder trial. And Casey's attorney, Jose Baez, grilled him in an aggressive cross-examination.
Also testifying today, two of Casey's ex-boyfriends. We have live team coverage. It starts with Bob Keeling at the WESH 2 Courthouse studio. And Bob, George Anthony had to do his best to keep his cool today.
Well, that's right. And you have to remember that now the defense team is trying to paint him as someone who is complicit in covering up his granddaughter's accidental drowning death. And today they suggested that that confrontation that he had with Casey over gas cans in their garage may have been something he just made up.
She was in and grabbed the gas cans. She said, here, I hate to say this, here's your gas cans.
During his second trip to the witness stand in the first 3 days of this trial, Casey Anthony's father, George Anthony, recounted confronting his daughter over two gas cans stolen from a shed in the family backyard. 8 days after Kaylee Anthony disappeared, George Anthony said his daughter raced past him to get to the trunk of her car before he did.
When she opened the trunk, did you look in the trunk?
Never had a chance to.
Did you call your daughter and ask her? Hey, did you take gas?
No.
During an aggressive cross-examination, George Anthony said the only thing he smelled at that time was gas from the cans.
And you did not smell any smell of human decomposition on June 24th of 2008 in the trunk of your daughter's car?
Did not.
In their attempts to paint George as complicit in a cover-up, the defense suggests Anthony and not his daughter had access to the rare form of tape later found on Kaylee's skull.
You're trying to confuse me here. Yes, you are, sir.
Anthony was rattled with Baez's repeated attempts to question his actions.
You're going off in a way to get me more upset, and I don't think that's fair.
Now, George Anthony came and went from the stand making little or no eye contact with his daughter. Meanwhile, the jury listened closely to his testimony, which was both sympathetic and believable. And any attempts Baez made to try and cast doubt on George Anthony's testimony was tempered by the fact that he had to be scolded several times by Judge Perry for improper questioning. Reporting live at our courthouse studio, I'm Bob Keeling, WESH 2 News.
WESH 2's team coverage continues now with Amanda Ober at the Orange County Courthouse. Amanda, a few emotional moments today during testimony from Casey's ex-boyfriends.
Yeah, the state put on a string of witnesses today, all who spent time with Casey during that crucial period of 2008 when Kaylee was missing. All of them were able to describe Casey's apparent happy-go-lucky behavior. But the most dramatic statement was one Casey allegedly made to one of these friends, bragging about her ability to lie. Melissa England, a woman who dated one of Casey's friends during the time Kaylee was missing, took the stand. She recalled Casey being happy and outgoing and says one night after Casey had told a lie to some friends, Casey bragged about it.
As she hung up, she said she kind of threw the phone down in the dashboard and just said, oh my God, I'm such a good liar.
I'm such a good liar.
Also testifying, Casey Anthony's old boyfriend, Ricardo Morales. He dated Casey from February to April of 2008, but they remained friends. He said Casey and Kaylee would sleep in his bed with him four nights a week while they were dating. Casey picked him up at the airport on July 15th, the day Kaylee was reported missing, and he said Casey seemed just fine.
She was the same as she always was.
And how is that?
Happy, smiling. She was asking us how our trip was. Just normal Casey.
The defense grilled Morales about photos of Casey and Kaylee he sold to the Globe newspaper for $4,000. They also brought up a picture Morales posted on MySpace that had the caption, "Win her over with chloroform." He said it was just a joke and Casey and he never discussed chloroform. As Baez asked Morales how Casey treated Kaylee, Morales did make an interesting comment.
Punish her in a method that would be considered torture.
No. She had issues with Kaylee going to sleep, but I don't know. That's the only time I saw her disciplining Kaylee.
You only saw her discipline Kaylee?
Now, Casey's boyfriend at the time that Kaylee disappeared was the first witness on the stand today, Tony Lazzaro. He described Kaylee and Casey's relationship as being loving and affectionate. And it was at that point that Casey Anthony reacted. She got very emotional and started dabbing tears from her eyes. Live outside the Orange County Courthouse, Amanda Ober, WESH 2 News.
Many bombshells, but some solid testimony that brought up a couple of questions. Judge O.H. Eaton joining me right now with his expertise, your perspective. So far, the prosecution has called two former boyfriends, half a dozen friends, Casey's father, and a neighbor to testify. On the surface, it seems very random, but is there a method here?
Well, I think there is. If you remember the prosecutor's opening statement, she was describing what events occurred on each of these 31 days, and they're calling witnesses basically in that order. So it sounds like it's random, but I don't think it is.
Judge Perry seems to be trying very hard to make sure that these jurors are taken care of. They asked to be able to see the Tampa Bay Lightning game. They also talked about snacks that they wanted, even organizing outings for their days off. Why?
Well, you know, when I was on the bench, I used to try my very best to take care of jurors because, after all, they're voters. And I would come up for election every now and then. But here we have a bunch of citizens who are basically in the custody of the sheriff, and they're going to be there for a long time. And it's important for their morale to be good. So I think Judge Perry is doing what he needs to do to try to bend over backwards and give them a few favors if they need it.
Make sure they're comfortable for what could be 2 months.
Could be, yes.
Judge Eaton, thank you. WESH 2's coverage of the case against Casey Anthony continues on our website. Today, Judge Perry became very upset and sent the jury out of the courtroom.